Get started by removing the seat and both main wires from the battery. Putting something over your front fender like a towel can help reduce dings in case of anything dropping during the installation. Remove the bike's outer fairing and put aside. Remove the headlamp assembly and put it aside. If you purchase the amplifier by itself and not as part of an amplifier speaker kit, you will need to attach the amplifier to the required RGRM4CH mounting plate. Locate the supplied power harness and plug it into the matching pigtail on the side of the amplifier. It's time to mount the amp in the bike under the radio as shown. Be careful to make sure the power harness does not get pinched. The mount arm on the power side of the amp will spring load itself into position as shown on this inner fairing structure we have out of the bike. The amp will be correctly positioned when the holes in the other arm line up with the holes on the bike where the headlight assembly gets attached. You will feel the amp click into place, and once it's in place, it's a good idea to secure the amp to the bike by installing one of the factory headlight bolts so the amp cannot fall out by accident. Locate the supplied input harness and plug it into the audio input socket on the end of the amplifier. Locate the output harness with brown and black and blue and black wires and plug it into the front out socket on the end of the amplifier. On the brake side of the bike, just above the air inlet, you will see a 2-pin connector with pink and pink with black stripe wires going through it. The plug is close to where the wires enter the brake side speaker cabinet. Separate the connector so you now have two plugs. From the amp, take the plug with blue and black wires and plug it into the mating plug you just separated, noting it will only go in one way. Also from the amp, take the plug with green and black wires and plug it into the mating plug you just separated, noting it will only go in one way. On the clutch side of the bike, just above the air inlet, you will see a 2-pin connector with pink and gray and pink with orange stripe wires going through it. The plug is close to where the wires enter the clutch side speaker cabinet. Separate the connector so you now have two plugs. From the amp, take the plug with brown and black wires and plug it into the mating plug you just separated, noting it will only go in one way. Also from the amp, take the plug with yellow and black wires and plug it into the mating plug you just separated, noting it will also only go in one way. On the brake side of the bike, to the left of the radio, there is a factory 2-pin plug with purple, with blue stripe, and black wire. You may have to pull back the sheathing to properly identify this plug. From the factory, the plug you're looking for has an empty connector in it that will need to be removed. Once removed, the orange wire on the amplifier's power harness must plug into this factory plug. The balance of the power harness will exit the inner fairing and go towards the frame of the bike through the wire passage from fairing to bike. Just in front of the tank, you will see a structure that attaches the fairing to the frame of the bike. The power harness will pass through this structure and exit through the rectangular opening where the factory harnesses also exit the structure. The wire harness can go under the tank towards the battery if you want, or you can run the power harness up and over the tank, but under the tank's chrome console. Once the red and black power wires are in the vicinity of the battery, you can attach the amplifier's wires to the battery. The factory power and ground wires are also reattached at this time. When attaching the wires to the battery, it's always a good practice to attach the power wire first. When the last connector is attached, some minor sparking is normal, as this is a function of the capacitors in the amplifier charging up. Wires for lids, lowers, or rears will go from in front of the tank, alongside the power harness, and work their way up near the amplifier. For lids or lowers, you will plug their wires into the rear out on the amp and make sure the fader, no fader switch goes to the no fader position. You can now use the three position switch to adjust the volume of the speakers plugged into the rear out on the amp. For rears on a Rode Glide Ultra, you will put the switch to the fader position, and depending on when your amp was made, you may have to plug into an empty socket on the amp's input harness as shown. Refer to your amplifier's manual to be sure. Just behind the seat, you will see a large connector that needs to be separated. The two plugs on the Hogtunes harness will plug into the factory plugs just separated. It is very important that you turn the front wheel to each extreme side, making sure that any wires cannot bind or impede the steering of the motorcycle. Failure to do so can cause an accident, resulting in serious injury. Turn the stereo on, and at low volume, test to make sure the speakers are working. Now is a good time to clean up and secure the wires using the supplied zip ties. Remove the bolts that are temporarily holding the amplifier and plate in place and get the headlight assembly. The headlamp bolts will now be reinstalled so that the bolt goes through the headlight assembly first, then the amplifier's plate, then into the threaded plate on the bike. Once you have the headlight assembly and amplifier in place and you are satisfied everything is secure, reinstall the bike seat and outer fairing, and your new system is ready to enjoy.